Michelle Obama said, and this, you know, obviously was very significant. She's raising some alarm bells as far as 2024 is concerned. She says she's terrified, her word, terrified about the election. Listen to this.
What's going to happen in this next election? I am terrified about what could possibly happen because our leaders matter. Who we select, who speaks for us, who holds that bully pulpit, it affects us in ways that sometimes I think people take for granted.
2016, also in 2012, when we took polls for Donald Trump, he did not fare particularly well, but he was completely unfazed. And I said, why? And he said, well, you don't understand, I'm not a candidate. As soon as I become a candidate, these poll numbers will change. I doubted that. I was completely wrong. As soon as he became a candidate, he skyrocketed in the polls. So I don't think people see her in that context, which is why you have this gap. It's very, very tricky to run against a woman at any level. It's very tricky. You come on,
especially in today's
time. Unless it's Hillary Clinton, who's particularly despised.
A lot of people are wondering how they allowed Biden to get this far. It's the question on some Democrats' minds this week, with many blaming the White House press corps. Jill Abramson, the former executive editor of the New York Times, wrote in Semaphore, quote, "It's clear the best news reporters in Washington have failed in the first duty of journalism to hold power accountable. It's our duty to poke through White House smokescreens, find out the truth. The Biden White House clearly succeeded in a massive cover-up of the degree of the president's feebleness and his serious physical decline, which may be simply the result of old age. Shame on the White House press corps for not having pierced the veil of secrecy surrounding the president." CNN is coming to a similar conclusion. In an article, CNN quotes a reporter who says, "The White House press shop has also been very aggressive and fairly successful in mitigating coverage of concerns over the president's age." The reporter essentially says the press corps knew how much age stories angered the White House and the liberal Twitter sphere.
CNN's Jake Tapper also blaming top Democratic officials for trying to convince the public that Joe Biden's in great shape. Take a look.
There is a pattern, discernible pattern, of Democratic officials seemingly trying to convince you, the public, to not believe what you saw and what you heard with your eyes and with your ears on Thursday night.
What I'm going to do is fix the tax system. For example, we have 1,000 trillionaires in America. I mean, billionaires in America. And what's happening? They're in a situation where they, in fact, pay 8.2% in taxes. If they just paid 24%, 25%, either one of those numbers, they'd raise $500 billion, I should say, in a 10-year period. We'd be able to wipe out his debt. We'd be able to help make sure that all those things we need to do, child care, elder care, making sure that we continue to strengthen our health care system, making sure that we're able to make every single solitary person eligible for what I've been able to do with everything we have to do with, look, if we finally beat Medicare.
Thank you, President Biden. President Trump?
Well, he's right. He did beat Medicare. He beat
right now, some interesting speculations are going around in the United States. Former Republican presidential candidate Vivek Ramaswamy has doubled down on his theory that Democrats will swap out President Joe Biden with Michelle Obama on their party's ticket. This comes after the release of the special counsel's report, which says Joe Biden has significant limitations in his memory. Speculations for the same became rife after Cindy Adam made a similar claim in the New York Post, as well as longtime Trump advisor Roger J. Stone Jr. predicted the same. Adding weight to the speculation, Adams pointed to Michelle Obama's expressed apprehensions about the 2024 election outcome in a podcast interview. Former First Lady had admitted to being terrified of Trump becoming the president again.
You know, Hezbollah is very smart. They're all very smart. The press doesn't like when they say it. But Hezbollah, they're very smart. They've got to straighten it out because they're fighting potentially a very big force. They're fighting potentially Iran. And when they have people saying the wrong things.
When making life or death, war or peace decisions, a president just can't pop off or lash out irrationally. No, we need an adult in the White House.
Damn!
It's about whether someone can handle the awesome responsibility of leading this country.
The president has to have immunity. And the other thing is, I did nothing wrong.
Hezbollah is very smart. They're all very smart. The press doesn't like when they say it. But Hezbollah, they're very smart. They've got to straighten it out because they're fighting potentially a very big force. They're fighting potentially Iran. And when they have people saying the wrong things.
When making life or death, war or peace decisions, a president just can't pop off or lash out irrationally. No, we need an adult in the White House.
Damn!
It's about whether someone can handle the awesome responsibility of leading this country.
I'm so proud of my husband and the way he led, the way his administration worked, the team that we built. So proud of everyone. I think that's because of who we are. And I know that now. I mean, the bars are different for people in life. That I've learned. This is the thing about being an other. You learn how to be excellent all the time because you can't be less than. Other people can. Other people can be indicted a bunch of times and still run for office. Black man can't. You just learn to be good. And in the end, you benefit from that extra resilience. You know, you could be mad about it, but it also makes you more equipped, right? But it's still not fair.
Yeah, definitely.